What's going on, everybody? Back rocking with Sweet Science. You on the air. Subscribe to the channel. Beat the like button up. And make sure you hit the bell icon and get all your post notifications moving forward. Because we talk boxing here, man. Real boxing. So my last video was it's pretty much a reaction video, really. To Dillian White getting slept by 41-year-old Alexander Povetkin. But that's not what I want to talk about today. Today I actually came to talk to y'all about the potential matchup. It looks like it could happen between Devin the Dream Haney and Mr. Gary Russell Jr. Now, we know Gary Russell Jr. has been talking a lot lately. He's said a lot of stuff about a lot of people, about Terrence Crawford. Stop playing with me, Terrence. Stop playing with me, Terrence. He said a lot of stuff about Terrence Crawford. I don't know how that would have worked out for him, but you know, he got the heart to do it. And he's talked about Gervonta Davis. That's a whole nother. I'm not gonna say who I think will win that in this video. That's for another video. And he's also talked about Leo Santa Cruz. Y'all should know who I would pick in that fight, because that's a no-brainer. Anybody trying to argue Gary Russell Jr. versus Leo Santa Cruz, please stop. But right now, today, we came to talk about Mr. Gary Russell Jr. versus Devin the Dream Haney. They've been going back and forth, and what it looks like is that they have the fight signed, or they're in negotiations to get it signed. Offer has been made, so we actually might get to see that fight. It's very likely we'll get to see that fight. Now, if I'm not mistaken, Gary Russell Jr. has the WBC belt at 135. And Devin Haney has a belt. I want to say it's the WBO. It could be the WBA belt at 135 also. So I believe that would be a unification match. Or you know what? Maybe Devin Haney has a version of the WBC belt. They got so many belts going around. You all know the story. And it's so hard to really find out who's who in each division because it's a million belts. But I do know that they're both title holders, at least for Devin Haney and Gary Russell Jr. Now, analyzing the fight, I just feel like it's not going to be an easy fight for either of the guys, just because it seems like the situation that's taking place between them two is becoming personal. Gary Russell Jr. said the Terrence Crawford situation was personal, but it looks like the Devin Haney situation is becoming personal as well. So you have to take things like that into pretty much into consideration when you think about these fights. You know, who's really, really real, who's really, really mad, really who has like motive to go extra hard, to train hard, to be more focused. You have to look at those things in addition to just the actual fight itself. Now, so just off the strength of that, I feel like, you know, I don't know. I feel like it could go either way. I feel like Devin Haney isn't taking Gary Russell Jr. as serious as he should. I think he takes him serious, but I don't think he takes him as serious as he should. And I think Gary Russell Jr. pretty much has a formula because he's been a champion longer. And I do think he takes Devin Haney more serious than Devin Haney takes him, based off of like how they talk and stuff like that. So with that being the case, once you get them two guys inside the ring, obviously we all should know, most of the time in the first 2-3 rounds, that's the filler out of the fight. You know, a lot, most of the time, does not happen in the first, you know, the first 3 rounds, most of the time in the average boxing match. So it's going to be pretty much like the filling out rounds, them first 2-3 rounds. Now, by the time you get to the 4th-5th round of any fight, you're watching the actual fight from that point. So I feel like personally, my prediction for that fight, I feel like defense-wise, Devin Haney's better. Just a tad. I'd give Devin Haney a 10 defense-wise. I'd give Gary Russell Jr. 8.5, 9 defense-wise. Because Gary Russell Jr. does get hit with more shots than Devin Haney. But he also takes the shot. So I give him an 8.5, 9 for his defense. On speed, I got Devin Haney. I got Devin Haney with a 10. As far as speed, Gary Russell Jr. I give 8.5, 9 as far as the speed. The ability to take a punch, I don't know, because I haven't really seen Devin Haney get cracked like that. At least nothing that comes to mind where I've seen him get hit with a solid shot and I'm like, getting hit with a shot like that is going to show what he's made of. But I can't really recall Devin Haney getting hit like that. And that could be a good thing or a bad thing. That could be a good thing because you could say his defense is so good, you know, being trained by the Mayweathers and his pops and stuff like that, that his defense is so good that he hasn't been hit with a shot like that. But you can also, on the flip side to that, say, well, because he hasn't got hit with a shot like that, we don't know how he's going to react to it if he does get hit with a shot like that. So, ability to take a punch, I'll probably edge that to Gary Russell Jr. just because I've seen Gary Russell Jr. get cracked. And he eats those like Skittles, you know what I'm saying? Not a lot, but when he has gotten cracked, he hasn't really been affected by it. Power, I'm going to give to Gary Russell Jr. I've seen Devin Haney hit guys with some hard shots. Like, you could tell he's putting his whole being into it, his whole soul force behind the punch. He's putting everything he's got into it, and he hasn't gotten guys out of there. I'm not to say he hasn't knocked anyone out. Don't be ridiculous, especially in the comments. Especially, never mind, I'm not even going to say that. I'll save that for another video. But power, I don't care what anybody says. I'm going to edge that to Gary Russell Jr. So I'll give, for their division as far as power, I'll give Gary Russell Jr. a 10. I'll give Devin Haney an 8.5. I don't know if I'll give him a 9. But I'll definitely give Devin Haney an 8.5. Now, with that being said, you know, Devin Haney would have to pretty much stay out of Gary Russell Jr.'s way for the whole fight, because I believe that if it comes to either of them two cracking each other in that fight, who's going to break first? I personally think Devin Haney's going to break first. You know what I'm saying? You know, Gary Russell Jr., he's just a tougher guy. He reminds me of the lunch pail guy on the construction site, that, you know, the hard boots. He's just a tougher guy. You know what I'm saying? So if it comes down to them cracking each other like that, I'm going to definitely give the edge to Gary Russell Jr. So if I had to say, I'd say the first three rounds, filler out, 4 or 5, you'll see a fight. 6, the fight will go on. 7, 8, 9, 10. It could go to decision. If it goes to decision, I think it's any man's game. You know, honestly, if it goes to decision because of his punch output and the way he dodges, it could go to Devin Haney if the fight goes to decision. But if the fight doesn't go to decision and Devin Haney gets himself cracked by the right Gary Russell Jr. shot, it could be over. So if a knockout does happen, that knockout is going to be by Gary Russell Jr. But with all that being said, aside from the fact that I think Devin Haney will get overzealous because, you know, of the banter back and forth, and he wants to prove something to himself and to Gary Russell Jr. and his father and stuff like that, he might lose sight of what he's really trying to do with this fight. That's why you can't let fights get personal. So I just think with all those ingredients added, you put those two in the ring, Mr. Gary Russell Jr., Devin the Dream Haney, I think it ends by knockout. What round, I don't know. But I think it ends by knockout, and the knockout is going to happen by Gary Russell Jr. So this is my fight prediction. Again, you rock it with Sweet Science on the airs. Please subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell icon, all that stuff. I'm coming with more videos. My next video, more than likely, is going to involve the Charlo unification with Jason Rosario and Jermall Charlo versus Derevyanchenko. That's next. But again, subscribe to the channel. Sweet Science, you on the air, and I'm out. Peace.